Protecting your privacy on iPhone is more important than ever. And with iOS 17, there are lots of new tools that make managing your privacy settings easier than ever. But as usual, hackers keep coming out with new ways to compromise your privacy. So we're gonna walk you through all the settings that really matter in this video, starting with app tracking transparency. I'll open the settings app and scroll down to privacy and security. Then second one from the top is tracking, tap on that. Here you'll find the option, allow apps to request to track. Flip this switch off and voila, you've just told your apps, no, you can't follow me around the internet. It's like putting on an invisibility cloak in the digital world. While we're here, let's talk about the app privacy report, your very own data surveillance system. To access this, we're gonna go to settings, which we're already in, tap back to privacy and security, and then I'm gonna scroll down and tap on app privacy report. Here you can turn it on and start seeing detailed reports of app activities. It's like having CCTV, is that still a thing? I think it is, for your data, showing you how often each app accesses your location, camera, microphone, and more. It's a great way to see who's been partying too hard with your personal information. Now let's talk about sprucing up your iPhone's password settings. It's time to clean up your digital house and make sure your locks are as strong as your love for coffee on Monday mornings. First off, the automatic verification code cleanup. It's like having a self-cleaning oven, but for your security codes. We'll tap back and then back to the main page of settings. We're gonna scroll down here to passwords as I drag the phone around and then tap on password options. Here you'll find cleanup automatically. Flip this switch and your iPhone will automatically start deleting verification codes after they've been used. When it comes to shared password and passkey management on your iPhone, it's kind of like being part of a secret club, but with digital keys instead of secret handshakes. Let's explore how to manage those shared secrets. To check if you're already a member of this exclusive password club, let's take a look in the passwords section of settings, and I have family passwords here. Let's tap on that, and then you can check to see if you're the owner or just a guest at this party. You can tap here on the number of members in your group, and I can see under group members that I, David Payette, am the owner of this group. Kind of like peeking into a VIP lounge to see if your name's on the list. Now, if you're the group owner and you need to remove someone from this group, maybe they're not partying responsibly, go to settings, password, and select the group, which is where we are now, and then remove the member. It's like telling someone, sorry, you can't dance on the table anymore. Remember, once you remove someone, they might still have keys to your accounts that you shared. So it's wise to change the locks, or in this metaphor, change your passwords, because they might have written them down somewhere. You never know. All right, let's tackle the art of blocking phone calls and messages from contacts you'd like to avoid. It's your digital do not disturb sign that goes even deeper than do not disturb in your iPhone. The journey begins in the land of settings. Where else? I'll tap on settings to open it and then tap back to the main page of settings. And for phone calls, you guessed it, we're gonna start in the phone menu. Here you'll find the block contacts section, which is your personal blacklist for unwanted callers. It's like having a bouncer for your phone calls. And it's kind of a nice trip down memory lane sometimes. You know, you get to see, oh wow, I've blocked a lot of people in my lifetime. How many people have you blocked over time? Leave a comment below. I'm actually be curious to know. Let's talk about FaceTime. Do you want to have no FaceTime with certain people? Well, let's tap back to settings and head to FaceTime and scroll all the way to the bottom. That's where you'll find blocked contacts. This is your tool for making sure your video chats are intruder-free. And what about messages? To block those texts you'd rather not receive, let's go back to settings and tap on messages. Under SMS or MMS, we'll scroll down there. Tap on blocked contacts to take a look at that list. Consider this the equivalent of a no junk mail sign on your digital text message inbox or something like that. If we've learned anything, it's that blocking someone in one app applies across all four: phone, FaceTime, messages, and mail. It's like a universal, you shall not pass for your selected contacts. And if you ever have a change of heart, unblocking is just as easy and also universal. Now let's talk about how to keep your digital footprints in Safari elusive. Word of the day. To start your covert browsing operations, let's open the Safari app. I'll swipe up from the bottom of the screen and open up Safari. This is your gateway to the internet without leaving a trail. Once you're in Safari, you're just a couple of taps away from private browsing mode and putting on your digital invisibility cloak. When using private browsing, your browsing details aren't saved and they aren't shared across your devices. So it's kind of like going to a masquerade ball where nobody knows who you are, nobody remembers that you were there. It's especially handy if you're in a situation where you need to look up information discreetly without leaving a breadcrumb trail for someone else to follow. To activate private browsing, tap the Tabs button at the bottom of the screen, then tap Private on the left-hand side. The search field background will change, signaling that you're now in stealth mode. One of my favorite things about private browsing mode in recent iOS versions is that it requires Face ID now to access it. As long as you've turned that setting on, I'll show you where to go for that. Let's head back to settings, tap on that, and I'll tap back and then back to the main page of settings. Then I'm gonna scroll down to Safari and tap on that. Then I'm going to scroll down to require Face ID to unlock private browsing. I think that is a great feature. It's like having a secret passageway in your house where you can sneak between rooms and nobody knows you did. Whenever we record a video like this, we get comments from people who tell us we're going too fast or we're going too slow. It makes our job kind of difficult. So what we decided to do is put together a free PDF guide for you that you can download with every setting we talk about in this video, and you can follow along at your own pace. All you need to do is join the Pay It Forward YouTube channel by clicking the join button below the video. Continuing our digital journey, let's talk about how to clear your browsing history and website data in Safari on your iPhone. You're giving your digital footprint a good scrub. To wipe your Safari slate clean, let's head back to Safari settings, which is where I am, and just tap clear history and website data. Now we have these awesome options where we can choose the last hour, today, today and yesterday, or all history. Bear in mind that if you do clear your history, you're gonna get logged out of all the websites you've logged into in the past. So that makes it kind of a pain in the butt to do. I don't clear my history as often as I used to. But if I were to tap clear history, and I'll do it for the last hour, it's like using a magic eraser on your digital past. Clearing your history in Safari is like throwing away the map after you've used it. It ensures that no one can retrace your steps, but you can't either. So when you need a fresh digital start, just head over to Safari settings and let the erasing magic begin. Now let's navigate to the world of location services on your iPhone. We're gonna decide whether you wanna be on the digital map or go off the grid for good, or land somewhere in between. So we'll tap back to settings in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, and we're gonna scroll up to privacy and security, tap on that, and then tap on location services. With location services, as we've talked about many times before, you can choose to share your location with specific apps or not. So it's kind of like you're playing hide and seek with your apps. When you turn off location services, you're telling your apps, you can't find me. But remember, even if you go into digital hiding, some third-party apps and websites might still be able to find ways to guess where you are. And for safety's sake, your device will still use your location for emergency calls. So think of location services as your way of saying, I'll let you know where I am, but only on my terms most of the time. It's about finding that sweet spot between being reachable and maintaining your privacy. Next, let's dive into the realm of sharing settings on your phone. This is where you get to manage your digital family dinner table. Who gets a seat and who doesn't? First off, family sharing. To manage your family sharing settings, we're gonna open settings again, and then we're gonna tap back and go to the very top of the screen, tap your name, and then tap family sharing. I'm the head of my digital family, and I know that because I'm labeled as the organizer. I have the power to remove anybody I want to. It's like I'm the captain of the family ship. I decide who stays aboard and who walks the plank. So be careful about who you let into this party. Next, we're gonna talk about location sharing. Again, not in the settings app, but in the Find My app. Let's open the Find My app and tap people in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen. The people tab shows you all the people you're sharing your location with and all the people who are sharing their location with you. For instance, I can see Dad right here is getting the car fixed, his car, that is. If you want to go off the grid for someone, just tap on them and select stop sharing my location if you see that. Or in my case, I'm not sharing my location with Dad, I just see share my location. It's like turning off a beacon that says here I am all the time. And it might save some battery life for you. Next, we'll talk about shared albums in photos because it's Christmas time, but you might not want to show your Christmas tree to everybody. Let's head to the Photos app, tap on Photos, then tap Albums, then scroll down here to Shared Albums and tap See All. Here's where you can see who's been peeking into your digital photo album. If you want to stop sharing an album with someone, tap on that album to open it up, then tap the little person circle thing, and then you'll see who's been invited at the top of the screen here. So I can tap on that person, even though he hasn't accepted the invitation yet, being an Android user and all, I can tap remove subscriber down at the bottom. If you're a subscriber to somebody else's album, nobody invites me to anything, so I can't demo that, but you can tap unsubscribe to bow out gracefully in much the same way. We've talked about people. Now let's talk about managing settings for those digital little sleuths we like to call AirTags and other Find My compatible accessories on your iPhone. To make sure an AirTag isn't tracking you right now, let's tap on me to access your personal settings. Here, you need to make sure that Bluetooth, location services, and tracking notifications are all turned on. To turn on tracking notifications, scroll to the bottom of this menu here and tap Customize Tracking Notifications. And just make sure that this Allow Notifications and Immediate Delivery is turned on. Remember, AirTags and other devices are great for keeping tabs on your belongings, but it's important to make sure they're not being used to keep tabs on you without your knowledge. Now we're gonna shift gears and talk about something a little bit more serious. The guidelines Apple has for law enforcement requests for data. This is like understanding the rules of engagement when the digital world meets the legal world. In cases where there's a need for law enforcement to request data related to another person's account, perhaps in situations of technology-enabled abuse, stalking, or harassment, there is a specific process to follow. This is not a DIY scenario. You do need to team up with local law enforcement or the courts. They're the ones who will submit a request on your behalf. Apple has a dedicated team within their legal department that manages and responds to all legal requests from law enforcement agencies globally. They're like the gatekeepers who ensure that these requests are handled properly. We decided to make this video a little bit more fun by inserting some AI-generated images throughout that help illustrate the points we're making. What do you think about that? Leave a comment below. We're interested to hear your thoughts. Let's run through a quick personal safety checklist to make sure your iPhone and your accounts are secure. Some digital housekeeping, if you will. We're gonna make sure that only the right people have the keys. First, let's check device access. To start, we're gonna go back to settings. I'll tap back and then back to the main page of settings. We're gonna tap on your name at the top. This is like checking the guest list for your digital party. If you scroll down, you can see all of the devices that you're signed into. If you spot a device that makes you go, huh? Like a mystery guest at a party, just tap on that device and select remove from account. It's like politely showing that guest the door. Second, let's talk about Face ID and Touch ID. While we're in the thick of securing your digital domain, it's a good idea to check for any unexpected alternate Face ID appearances or additional Touch ID fingerprints. I'll tap back to settings and I'll scroll down to, in my case, Face ID and passcode. And I'll enter my passcode. And then I don't have an alternate appearance set up here where it says set up an alternate appearance. If you do and you didn't set it up, somebody else might have access to your phone. Same idea with extra fingerprints that are added. We're just double checking here that your locks are secure and only the right people have access. Now let's talk about lockdown mode. It's not your average security setting. It's the digital equivalent of turning your phone into a security fortress when facing a siege of state-sponsored mercenary spyware. To turn on lockdown mode, it's simple. Tap back to settings, then tap privacy and security. It's a few settings below where we were. Then scroll to the bottom, tap lockdown mode. This is the highest security alert level in your digital kingdom. It's the break glass only in case of emergency option for when you suspect you're the target of a sophisticated cyber attack. Not your everyday eavesdropping, but James Bond movie kind of stuff. What happens when you go into lockdown mode? Well, your iPhone goes into a sort of digital hibernation. It's like having a bouncer for your web browser, only letting in the VIPs. What about Apple services? If someone hasn't called or sent you a request before, they won't even be able to reach you via Apple services like FaceTime. What about connecting your phone to your computer to transfer music to iTunes? Can't do it. Lockdown mode. You can't do much in lockdown mode. Now it's time to delve into the world of managing your privacy and security settings on your iPhone all from one place. Remember, in this high-tech world, your personal information is like a secret recipe. You don't want it falling into the wrong hands. Basically the same thing as your grandma's apple pie recipe. So let's get into how you can use Safety Check to protect your digital life, shall we? Safety Check is a great feature, but remember, you do need to have iOS 16 or later on your phone to use it. If you're watching this video, you probably do. Let's tap back to the main page of Privacy and Security, and now we're gonna tap on Safety Check. Tap on that. We've got a couple of options here. First, emergency reset. This is your emergency shutoff switch for sharing. It's like telling everybody talk to the hand because the iPhone ain't listening. You can immediately stop all types of sharing and reset settings associated with your Apple ID. But for those of you who like to get into the nitty-gritty, you can tap on Manage Sharing and Access. And this is perfect for a detailed review and reset of the information you're sharing with other people and apps. You can also update your device and Apple ID security here. It's like playing detective with your own digital footprint. So how does Safety Check keep you safe? It lets you take control of who's privy to your information. You can restrict messages and FaceTime to your iPhone, reset system privacy permissions for apps, change your passcode, update your Apple ID password, and more. Remember, managing privacy and security settings on your iPhone is not just about keeping things under wraps. It's about ensuring that your digital life is as orderly and secure as your sock drawer. Next, let's talk about why you might want to restore your iPhone to factory settings. To reset your phone, we're gonna start in settings, as usual. So I'm just gonna tap cancel here and tap back to settings, and we're gonna scroll up to general. So we'll tap on general and scroll to the bottom, tap on transfer or reset iPhone, and then you can tap erase all content and settings there. This is the point of no return. Once you tap this, your iPhone will forget everything it ever knew. After you tap the button, you're gonna need to enter your passcode and your Apple ID password to wipe the slate clean. Then sit back and wait for your iPhone to erase everything and return to normal. If you're really concerned about your privacy, however, make sure you don't restore from an iCloud backup that you set up your phone as new. It's okay to sign into iCloud because then you're gonna download your contacts and those important things, but the actual backup could contain the same privacy issues that caused you to want to reset your phone in the first place. And it's kind of like getting a brand new phone without the new phone smell. Stay safe, stay smart. Most importantly, stay in control of your digital world.
She was sitting in a really weird spot underneath the table.
Did she have her head on the
thing?
I took the same picture.
Okay.
Yesterday.
So it's not, she, it's not.
I thought she, it looks like she's like choking herself
or
something.
Yeah, I was like, what is she doing?
What are you doing?
She's like to be there now.